The Luo people of East Africa have spoken of night runners for generations. They are said to be villagers possessed by a demonic spirit, which compels them to scare and terrorize their neighbors at night. But no one really knows who the night runners are. Tonight, we're hoping to catch one on camera for the first time. Every night at 10 p.m., Margaret Onyango and her four grandchildren start to hear strange sounds coming from outside their hut. We placed a secret camera outside her house to try to catch the night runner in action. And we succeed. Her grandchildren are awoken by the commotion. This scene is repeated across rural Kenya nightly. But it's all shrouded in secrecy. No one even knows how many night runners exist. They don't attack or steal from their target. Their only goal appears to be scaring the neighbors. So who are they and what possesses them? I'm an investigative reporter based out of Nairobi, and I'm also Luo. I was brought up on my father's tales about the night runners. But now I've seen a real one. I'm determined to find out what truly lies at the heart of this bizarre ancient tradition. For my people, the Luo, night running is one of their greatest myths. But unlike other folklore, this one actually exists. I have acquired video footage that is, to the best of my knowledge, the only recorded evidence of night running. But are these people really possessed by demonic powers? That's what I'm here to find out. It's a question many Luos seem unable or too afraid to answer. The severe stigma associated with night running is enough to seal more sleeps in the community. Maybe Margaret, the elderly grandmother whose regular ordeal we filmed last night, can shed some light on why they do what they do. What problems does this night runner cause for you and your family? But Margaret seems too frightened to confront the night runner. Maybe showing Margaret the footage will make her less afraid.
Hey. I'm a leech man. One with me, I'm gonna neno kanya neno niyana.
After seeing the night runner in action, Margaret seems more scared than ever.
Mama, Now that we've shown you video evidence of a night runner who's been disturbing you, what do you plan to do about it? What do you think causes night running? Do you think there are people who are possessed by demons?
It's very difficult to get night runners to open up about their nocturnal activities. But I've finally managed to find two who have agreed to speak about what they do and how they started on camera. This is husband and wife, Sam Otieno and Grace Awino. They're subsistence farmers who live on the north side of the same village with their two young children. I'm hoping this evening they might even let us film them running too.
Nimepata kikebe kidogo, likuwa mawe tatu na mchanga. Alafu nimepita hiyo kikebe. Hapo ndiyo nimetafuta hiyo kazi. Baba yangu ndiyo aliacha hiyo kitu baada ya kufariki. Aliacha hiyo kitu kando ya nyumba.
That was 9 years ago. And Sam has been night running ever since.
Nafanya hivi kwa rufi. Hiyo inastuka watu kwa nyumba. Alafu nikisikia kama wanafanya, hey, hiyo ni nani? Huyo ni nani? Nafurahia.
Kusikia watu wamesikia.
I feel very happy.
Night running appears to be passed down through families, from one generation to another. But while Sam believes he inherited the spirit from his father, Grace, as an outsider marrying into a night running family, says she was converted.
Nilifanyika kama kila siku alikuwa anatokanga na nikajiuliza, huyu mtu anaenda ngapi ama ako na mama mwingine nje?
Instead of coming clean to Grace, Sam chose to lay a small trap at their front door.
Nikapata jivu mwingine hapo akifunga na mawe akifunga pamoja. Nilipita kwa mlango. Sasa ikifika usiku nikaanza kumpata. Mara ya tatu nikaanza kupata njia yangu sasa.
Running solo minimizes the chances of getting caught. So aside from when someone is being converted, night runners say they never work in pairs or groups.
Have you ever been caught?
Nilishaishikwa na hapo hao walikuwa wanategea. Wamefunga nyumba na wameweka nini kitu kidogo ndani ya nyumba. Nikienda kunini nyumba mlango hivi na mlango nimeingia mpaka ndani.
Could you show us how?
Yani, nimeanza kufanya hivi, nimekuja kufanya tisi hivi hivi alafu na hivi nikikuja nikifanya alafu nikastuka nikafanya unisamee. Alafu wana kusamea.
Kitu gani ingine huo ufanya kwa boma ya mtu?
Nafanya na mtu akitokea na kabla haja kutokea nafanya hivi.
Wapi sasa?
Na saruka hivi na nasikia kama wanaongea juu yangu. Wakiongea nakuja na kukufanya hivi tena. Yeah. Naweza fanya.
Unamwaga ndani.
Eh, naweza fanya.
What if they open the door and come out?
Wakifunga nyumba na nakimbia.
But Sam doesn't always make a clean getaway. It turns out he's been caught more than once, and he's put his family in serious danger as a result.
Amenisika mara mbili kwa hiyo boma moja.
What did they do to you the second time?
Mwenye nyumba mkubwa ananibebea panga. Anataka kukata singo langu. Walikuwa anataka ng'ombe.
A cow?
Yeah. Na sikuwa na hiyo pesa yenye anaweza nini. Yanaweza pea hiyo cow.
So you still owe him?
Yeah. Yeah.
People get hurt when they get caught. Do you think it's worth it?
Yeah, it is worth
it. It is worth it?
Yeah.
And there's nothing which can make you stop?
Even death.
The family live under constant threat of being exposed by the victim they haven't paid off. And if the rest of the neighbors do find out, they could be banished from the village or worse. Grace has decided that's enough reason to stop. But she says, if she doesn't run, the spirit makes her suffer.
Inasikia aka niko mgonjwa kidogo kidogo. Lazima nikimbie ndio nirudi. Ndio nitakuwa comfortable.
Sasa imefika wakati ili siwezi kuachia hiyo.
Don't you see there's other people see this activity that you do as being malicious?
Kuna watu wamekataa hiyo kazi. Nifanye, lakini kwangu, hiyo ni kazi yangu.
You don't see a problem with it?
Problem, nikienda, naweza rudi kama mguu yangu imevunjika. Kuna kidonda.
Is it an addiction?
It is an addiction.
The couple invite me to share a specially prepared meal they always eat before running.
Hii ukikula. Hautashikwa kwa urahisi.
They say it's what the spirit wants.
Mimi nahitaji ile baridi. Sasa hii itabidi ni kwe baridi.
Ukimpita unampita tu hivyo.
Na watu hawajaona.
Au ni yeye?
So the cold food makes you invisible.
Yeah.
After dinner, the couple start to feel the urge to run. Grace allows our camera to follow as she conducts her nocturnal rounds. The night is now pitch black, so we switch to infrared. She goes to her favorite homestead. Rubs a stick along the roof. Knocks and rattles on the door. Throws stones and clumps of earth. But the household wakes up, and an elderly woman inside becomes very angry. Grace beats a hasty retreat. As Grace arrives home, Sam realizes she's picked up an injury.
Nikifika huku nasikia kelele za huku sasa nikarudi bio.
So you're concerned about her safety?
Yeah. Niliogopa kama nikisasikia hiyo kelele, niliogopa kama nimedhani kama wao wamesika. Yeah.
Ndio nimeanguka. Nimekuti naisikia uchungu.
Mungu.
Menipigia kelele.
I can see Grace is scared, but I can't help sympathizing with the residents she's harassing. They have the right to get angry when their sleep is disturbed and their property invaded on a near nightly basis. Chief Abel Olang finds himself regularly mediating in similar disputes over night running. I join him on a visit to one of his regular complainants.
Mama Karen has had repeated cases of night running, night runner coming to disturb her, and at times they've even taken her livestock from where they've been secured and taken them. Destroying crops in people's farms in the night.
How frequent are night running cases in this area?
I receive several reports on night running cases, but it's difficult to prosecute them. They don't want to confront the night runners on the table.
Why?
Cultural beliefs. Some say that if you mention a night runner openly, then maybe you are keen, will also become night runners.
There are no Kenyan laws specific to night running. But in theory, at least, practitioners who are caught could be charged with public disturbance or trespass.
And trespass, yes. Mama Karen. Mama Karen, akelo ni wendo.
Ay, timo maber.
Hey. Ndiyo, karibu. Karen, abiro ngeyo nito bende ngat mane iri mane gonyo ni dhiang mane chandi cha nyaka ne ikel na report cha be osechako duogo kendo
nyicha gi oduogo machiegni koro anawe no dwa kawo sola mane vitado cha kecha winjo ko chalo ng'ama ywa tado kama mapenjo ni mano ng'a koro kamenyo toch kama gi ote gi to kachaka winjo yajuok nitie kendo gi ide style mopogore opogore nitie maololo. Nitie manyalo kao kata chieth dhiang' madir kuomi kamininde. Jajuok no okao kudho modhi ochwe thundi dhiang' minyiedho. Maka kiny piny ruto kimako thundi dhiang' to dhiang' ywaka ywaka. Oira nikech koro ang'ama dhako an kakenda. Jajuok nyalo iri mapiny maki.
What I've noticed, there's a tendency of mostly widows who don't have a man in the house at night are the ones who are targets.
Those are the reported cases.
Yes. According to my personal observation, yes.
Sam and Grace describe the night running as funny games. But to other villagers, particularly elderly widows like Mama Karen or Margaret, they cause fear, harassment, and anger. And sometimes those emotions boil over into violence. Something Samuel Odoyo knows all too well. He wants to warn Sam and Grace to stop before it's too late.
Mimi nilikuwa natrana. Kuna babu yangu ingine hapo ndio alinipea hiyo kitu. Sasa vile nilienda kufanya hiyo kazi yangu kama naenda vile nilikuwa naendanga kila siku na watu walinitega alafu wakanichoma na maji moto na mimi vile nilibambana na hao nilibambana mpaka nikatoka mbio.
Rather than seeking medical attention, Samuel's first thought was to preserve his secret life from the rest of the village. he ran home and set his own house on fire.
Nilikuwa nataka watu wasijue ni nini ilinichoma. Sasa wakipata nyumba inawaka na moto hapo watasema oh huyu jamaa ametoka kwa hii moto ndio maana amechomeka.
For Samuel, losing his house was a better fate than his family being kicked out of the village, or worse, if he was fully exposed. To show the couple how bad it can get, he is willing to reveal the full extent of his injuries.
Sitali nimekaa mwezi moja.
Ukicha kidieti si yake wangu.
Nisanipo kadieti chikendo. Nyaka wangu. Chunya to gombo ni munda dee. Toka nyala dee ni kechpoda ngiremu.
Natumia mikono kwa unafanya kazi. Nasa hizi mkono yangu ya huku, hawezi fanya kitu. Ya huku pia bado niko na uchungu.
Mimi vile naweza kuwaambia sasa wanaweza kuacha bila bado ni wazima hawajapata majeraha vile mimi niko nayo wanaweza tu kuacha hiyo kitu.
Maybe this is the moment Sam will see just how risky his choices are for his family.
Now that you've seen a consequence of night running, it will help you make a decision to stop.
I'm going to go to the house. Sahi hawezi enda kazi na kuna watoto, akona bibi. Si vizuri kabisa. Then tuachane na hiyo kazi kabisa. Mimi naona niko peke yangu. Kila mtu atabeba mzigo wake mwenyewe sasa.
It was our hope that this meeting will help the young couple to make a decision on whether they should continue night running or not. But this seems to be a point of divergence. From what we've seen and what we've heard from other night runners, it gets to a point where people separate or divorce because of night running.
Grace seems committed to stopping now, but many night runners appear unable to quit. Sulmena Anyango, a widow and 50-something construction worker, has been night running for the best part of 30 years. Her story bears a lot of similarities with Grace's. But unlike Grace, she didn't stop, and now she says she never can.
Hey, Sulmena.
Hi.
Asante.
Thank you.
Tuambie, tell us, when did you become a night runner and how?
Nimekuja hapa kuolewa na nimepata tu kwa bwana yangu.
So you found your husband doing it?
Yeah.
How did he make you become one?
Si ametoka tu, anaanza tu kukimbia, ananiacha, anaingia tu, anakimbia hivi. Sijui anafanya nini na mimi nime fata tu nini hiyo. Eh, na mapenzi ilikuwa inashikana.
Kuna mpenda sana.
Eh.
Okay.
Sasa nimefanya tu vile kitu yeye anafanya. Wakati nimeanza sitaki tu mtu ajue, lakini saa hii nimejua. Kila mtu amejua na ati mimi ni anatrana.
Sasa
siwezi kuficha.
What do you do when you run?
Nimekimbia, nimechukua tu vitu zangu ziko tu hapo. Sasa nimeweka tu pale. Alafu nimechukua chupa, nikaenda tu nikakojoa. Nikachukua tu hiyo maji, nikamwaga tu hivi. hivi. Akifanya tu hivi nimesikia tu kama nimekuwa tu na raha.
Unakuwa na raha.
Yeah.
Sana.
But there is one thing that still plays on Sulmena's mind when she's running.
To right na ko joka. Tike samore jalukata ndega. Yeah.
Sulmena's urine fetish sounds like a way to make the experience more extreme. Perhaps over time, night runners need to take ever greater risks to get their thrills. Night falls and Sulmena begins to feel the urge to run. She steps out of her hut and her desire slowly intensifies.
Nimesema tu akikuja, nimestuka tu mara moja.
She picks up her favorite stick and an empty water bottle. Then she begins to run towards neighboring homesteads. After some time, she comes to her target and begins to circle and plot her next move. She rubs her favorite stick along the roof, a ritualistic warning to her victim before she sprays their house. She squats down, bottle in hand, to fill it with urine. Then, just as she's making ready, a man emerges from the house, swinging a machete. Her victim has turned the tables and laid a trap for Sulmena. She bolts and escapes, but my director, filming her, is not so lucky. The man chases him, lunging and swiping with his blade. Finally, a member of our crew is able to intervene and calm the property owner down. Sulmena hides in nearby bushes, then sneaks off while we distract him. But it feels like a close shave. Things could have turned out so much worse. It's clear Sam and Grace are taking terrible risks every night they run. And Sam remains convinced he can't stop. But there might just be another option. There's a man who wants to save night running from being outlawed by turning it, believe it or not, into an official sport. I've seen him in recent reports on television and in the national press.
I am a hero, like other heroes. So I'm the first elected president of veterans in Kenya, in East Africa, and in the world.
Jack Songo claims to be the president of a national Kenyan association for night runners. He says he can protect both his members and the public by providing a controlled space for those afflicted by the curse to let their inner demons out. He's even demanding that the Kenyan government recognize and fund the association.
Mr. Tom, how are you, my friend? You are arriving here?
Yes, I
am. I'm pulling this wheelbarrow in this market.
Okay. I thought the president should be sitting back and watching over.
Yes, I'm the poorest president in the world, my friend.
The poorest president in the world?
In the world, I'm the poorest in president. I am elected like other presidents.
But
I'm staying in a hard life, my friend.
Hey, there you are.
By day, President Songo carries goods for customers in this busy market.
Amarejaji wa kwa domera wa mosi. Dr. John Dungihan.
Jackson.
Yes, thank you.
You're very well known here.
Yes, I'm a famous person.
You're a famous person?
Yes, I'm a national figure. Yes.
How old were you when you started? And how long have you been doing it?
Around 17 years old. From 1992, there, up to now.
What do you do when you night run?
We are jumping, we are dancing, and we are operating some wild animals. We have a giraffe there, elephant, a crocodile, and buffaloes. We tame them. Also, this is our area. We have so many types of hyenas and leopards in this area.
I've seen some strange things with Sam and Grace. Perhaps some even stranger with Sulmena, but nothing like this.
Yes.
So you ride on hyenas?
Yes, we are operating them. We are operate them.
When was the last time you rode a hyena?
Like last night.
Last night?
Yes.
To what purpose?
To entertain, for just entertainment.
Can you show us you riding hyena?
We can wait until night, not now.
So you'll show us how you ride a hyena at night?
Yes.
Jack claims that under his leadership, the Association of Nightrunners has actually outlawed the kind of activities we've seen Grace and Sam engaging in.
Now, yes. In this our new constitution, knocking the doors and the roofs, now it is out of the law now. You cannot operate like now.
He believes the only way to keep nightrunning alive is to get the Kenyan government to officially recognize his new form of the activity as a sport. That way, he can get funding from the state to put on official night running events.
Tell us, what is the Night Runners Association? Has it been registered?
I am still fighting to get our recognition, but the Kenya's government cannot recognize this, our activities.
They give you reasons.
I wrote a letter to the former Minister of Sports, Art and Culture. I wrote a letter to his office.
Did you get a response?
I cannot get any result from them or from that office.
I'm hopeful this association could provide Sam with the outlet he still clearly needs. But I'm starting to doubt if Jack could have managed to get enough other night runners to sign up to his leadership and new constitution.
How many members do you have? How large is your network?
I was elected by 1.3
yes. Million votes.
Yes.
So you want to claim that 1.3 million night runners gathered and yes. Voted for you?
Yes. In different counties.
In different counties?
Yes.
Is there a membership fee?
Yes. It is 5,000 now, non-refundable.
Now, 5,000 times 1 million. That's. Yes. 5 billion.
Yes.
And yet you're pushing a wheelbarrow in the market.
Yes.
Jack claims to be presiding over an organization bringing in annual membership fees of over $50 million. I am not convinced, but I am eager for night to fall. He's promised to put on a display of his new form of night running, including breathing fire and riding on a hyena. We arrive at a field he describes as the Night Runner State House, just as the president and three colleagues have got a fire going and appear to be warming up. They seem to draw energy from the flames, then wrestle and mime different actions performed on one another in a bizarre dance. Suddenly, they switch to a sports warm-up. Before the president begins to berate his members for their poor form. That provokes a burst of laughter. Then they pick burning embers from the fire. And launch into a series of games that revolve around chasing one another. Or wrestling over a calabash. It's all quite strange and not much like night running at all. Next, they pretend to make one another drink from the calabash, despite the fact that it's empty. It's an odd blend of the sporting and spiritual. And if I'm honest, I can't see it taking off. As the activity winds down, President Songo has a stern message for his followers.
As from today onwards, I don't want anybody to go to knocking the somebody's doors and somebody's roof. That's the out of the law now. I'm talking as a president. Yes.
They seem to be having fun, but it doesn't look like a serious solution for night runners like Grace and Sam, who say they are struggling with an addiction. And I'm also disappointed that Jack hasn't delivered on what he promised to show us.
The whole concept he's trying to push through about night running being a sport and its membership of 1.3 million or 2.6 million seems to be a fantasy. Also, he said he will show us running with the hyenas. But when we came here, for demonstration, none of that is evident. I don't think this is a solution for many night runners who want to quit.
It's clear that actually quitting night running is Grace and Sam's only option if they want to protect their family. But on my return to the village, it seems that despite vowing to quit last time I saw her, Grace's urge to run has just been too strong.
Pa.
Nini ba?
Mguu mchungu. Niliumia. Kenda kwa kazi yangu ya kawaida.
Ni ile mguu uko umeumia juzi.
Eh. Sasa ni hapa. Tayari pia unaweza angalia kifura. Naweza ona. Yote imefura. Na hapa pia imefura. You can see it's different from this one.
Nini ilifanyika?
Hiyo siku, nikazurura kidogo, nikafanya kazi yangu. Sasa, nikifika kwa mlango yake, nisha anguka hivi. Kumbe alienda kwa choo. Sasa kuenda kwa choo, kumbe alikuwa naniona. Akanigonga hivi ngumi, alafu akanishika hapa. Akanigonga hapa ngumi. Sunaona? Unawezaona? Hiyo ni ngumi yake alifanya hivi. Akamwambia unataka kunifanyia nini? Akaniambia, I want to rape you. Nikasema, wow, unisamee. Kaza kuntoa mangu. Sasa nilikuwa na nguvu nyingine hapo nikamrusha huu chini. Kisha mrusha tukatoka mbio.
How does this experience make you feel about night running?
No. Naona niache hiyo kazi kabisa. Siitaki tena na siipendi. Ya hali nipata kwake, anasema anataka mbuzi ama kondoo. Ndio achane na hiyo story. La, si hivyo. Atanichukulia hatua ingine mbaya.
Has he given you a deadline?
Aliniambia hiyo kitu anaitaka kesho ama kesho kutwa. Nikamwambia ni sawa nitajaribu venye naweza.
Are you afraid?
Yeah, I'm afraid.
Grace's nighttime activities have finally caught up with her. And she's in serious trouble with her neighbors. If the situation escalates, her whole family could be driven from their home. But she doesn't want to report the case to the police. All I can do is help her get treatment for her injured leg. We drive to the nearest town and arrange an appointment for Grace with a local medic.
Jua nimekaa sana, sasa nimekunjana. Nimekunjana, sasa kunajua kikanyaga chini hivi. Jaribu kustress kwa nguvu.
Sam has been looking for work in town and joins us at the clinic. Shortly before, clinical officer Josh Olang invites Grace in for a consultation.
Ulikuwa na shida gani?
Nilikuwa na shida kwa mguu.
Kwa mguu. Mguu nini kwa mbaya?
Nimevunjika.
Nimevunjika?
Eh.
Okay. Na what happened? Ulikuwa na shida gani? Shida nini tena?
Nilikuwa nakimbia usiku.
Ulikuwa nakimbia usiku?
Ndio nikapata hii accident.
Okay.
Nikaanguka chini.
Tukaanguka chini?
Yeah.
Okay.
Grace is clearly nervous about disclosing too much. As a night runner, she's used to keeping her activities secret, and it takes a lot to talk about them in this public setting.
Any other place? Kuna mali tena uliumia?
Eh, niliumia hapa. Nikapigwa ngumi.
Okay. Hebu ni. Niliona. Okay. Yes, sasa.
Naweza shika usikie.
Oh, yeah, ni hapo.
Eh, ni hapo.
Okay.
Yeah. Najua ukipini hapo.
Na hapa pia nauma.
Ni hapo ndi nauma sana hata kushinda hapa.
Okay.
Hii magoti. Kuja angalia huku mgongo.
Oh, mgongo?
Walikuwa ananichapa chapa na mpana.
Pale. Yeah. Oh, I have seen. Nimeona. So, I'm just suspecting there's a fracture of the toes. And we don't expect her to walk a lot. Yes. Yeah, so this is your paper.
Yeah.
You'll go to where they give the injection. Yeah. They'll give you this injection.
It's a relief to hear Grace's injuries are not too serious. But next time, she may not be so lucky. While she gets an injection to bring down the swelling in her leg, Mr. Olang tells me Grace is far from the first night runner he's treated.
These are common injuries with these people who normally run at night. I've just treated many people who have been beaten. Yeah, people have sustained injuries.
Would you say night running in Homa Bay is a public health risk?
Yeah, because it is happening in so many. It is so many. But people do not tell the truth.
Outside, I catch up with Sam. It seems he's finally having a change of heart.
Do you want to leave the night time? Then I say, I want to leave because here, kila saa, seeing that this is not at my end. Because kama mimi na umia mkuu yangu, pia yeye na mkuu. Hakuna mwenye atafika na watoto. Hakuna mwenye atafanya kazi kwa nyumba. Sasa naona kama tuwache.
This is a turning point for Sam and Grace. Sam now wants to quit night running. Grace was determined before to quit, but her latest injuries have convinced Sam that their nightly activities are a danger to their family and to their well-being.
They seem determined, and I am hopeful Sam and Grace can now avoid ending up badly injured like Samuel Odoyo, or trapped in an endless cycle of night running like Sulmena. But the following morning, I receive a panicked phone call from Grace. Because she failed to pay him for his silence, the villager who attacked her two nights ago has now outed her to the entire community as a night runner. Her family has been expelled from their home.
Nituletea shida mpaka tukasema afadhali tutoke hapo. Tuliogopa kuna anaongea, tukachukua watoto wetu tukaenda mwingine huko ndani kidogo, si sana, tukaenda tukaa.
Only one option remains. Grace's fellow villagers believe a traditional healer's medicine can remove the night running curse. Maybe if Grace appears to be cured by such a herbalist, the community will let her family come back.
Koro kaka imedo chamo yath, e kaka gino be medo weyi.
What does the treatment do to rectify whatever happened to them?
Gicho chalo kaka saitan. Koro mane gima golo kuome.
Before the ritual can begin, Grace pays the herbalist fee of 6,000 shillings or $60.
6,000.
Kete mesa. Koro katieti tachungo. Namwaga hii dawa ya kunywa. Anakunywa dawa. Lamba. Mai kero, kero na iwiye. Mano gi magolo saitande cha. Na mwaga dawa. Tede nindo. Tenango.
Aya, ero kamano.
Grace's only hope now is that her community believes the traditional healer spell has been successful. And her night running days are behind her. But if less stigma was attached to night running, we could gain a better understanding of how to help those afflicted by it.
Growing up, a lot of our parents from Western Kenya would emphasize about night running, made it look scary. So we grew up with a lot of fear about the activity and the people who do it. But since I came here, I found a different thing altogether. They are normal people, and they seem to be struggling. It may be mysticism, it may be a cultural belief, it may be mass psychosis.
Or perhaps a more modern approach to rehabilitation could save numerous lives from being destroyed.
For me now, night running seems to be a thrill-seeking activity. Many of those who engage in this practice seem to be addicted to the adrenaline of scaring people.
But if all the night runners stop, will we Luos be losing one of our oldest cultural traditions?
Many of the current generation want to quit because it has become increasingly dangerous to be a night runner. I wonder, in 20 or 30 years, will there be any night runners left?